azeotropic mixtures are constant volume mixtures. In the last topic we have discussed non-ideal solutions. In that I said that fractional distillation of a non-ideal solution uses only one component of pure state, but other component is obtained as an azeotropic mixture. Whereas for ideal solution, fractional distillation gives each component in the pure state. So what is this azeotropic mixture? Also called constant volume mixtures. So these are the liquid mixtures. These are the liquid mixtures which have same composition in the liquid phase and vapor phase, and they boil at a constant boiling point. On heating also their composition does not change. So azeotropic mixture, they have same composition in both liquid and gas phases. Liquid and gas phases, that means vapor phases, they have same composition. That means if you take some non-ideal solution, which is liquid mixture, where two components A and B are present, let the liquid mixture composition XA plus XB. Okay, so these are all vapors of A and B. This vapor phase composition is on YA plus YB. Here, see, XA for azeotropic mixture, what happens is XA is equal to YA. Okay, similarly, XB is equal to YB. That means both in liquid phase, vapor phase, same composition, mole fraction of a component in the liquid phase is equal to mole fraction of that component in the vapor phase. Next, you know, they have a constant boiling point. Constant boiling point. If you take this mixture with this composition, whatever the components present, if the composition of both liquid phase and vapor phase same, then what happens? Boils at the same temperature. So they have constant boiling point. Not only that, on heating also, composition does not change. Its composition does not change. So that is about azeotropic mixture. What is azeotropic mixture? A liquid mixture which has same composition in liquid and vapor phase is said to be azeotropic mixture or constant boiling mixture. Why it is called as constant boiling mixture? Because with this composition it has fixed boiling point. Okay, so on heating what happens? Because of evaporation, on heating evaporation increases. Because of evaporation, liquid content decreases. In the last drop left also, on heating, the last drop left also contains the same composition. XA, XB, some composition is there now. That is, throughout the heating, the composition is maintained constant. Similarly, in the vapor phase also, the composition is maintained constant on heating. That is azeotropic mixture. Got it. Now, azeotropic mixtures are of two types. These are of two types. Azeotropic mixtures are of two types. First one, A. Minimum boiling azeotropes. Second one, maximum boiling azeotropes. Let's see about each type of some points. First, about minimum boiling azeotrope. Minimum boiling azeotrope. You know, this type of azeotrope is formed by non-ideal solution. Non-ideal solution which shows positive deviation from the Raoult's law. So this azeotropy is formed by the non-ideal solution which shows positive deviation from the Raoult's law. Raoult's law. Okay. Let's see an example for it. In this, why it is said to be limbic boiling azeotrope? This mixture is having lesser boiling point than the food components. So here, boiling point of mixture, this azeotropic mixture, is less than boiling points of two pure components or boiling point of any pure component. See an example for it. Ethyl alcohol and water mixture. Already I have given that example in positive deviation. So ethyl alcohol C2H5OH. When it is taken 95.6% by mass and water remaining means 4.4%. These percentages are taken by mass. They will form an azeotrope. This mixture gives an azeotrope. Which kind of azeotrope? Positive deviation. That means minimum boiling azeotrope. You know, ethyl alcohol and water, it is a non-ideal solution which shows positive deviation. So, solution which shows positive deviation form minimum boiling azeotrope. Positive deviation means more vapor pressures. More vapor pressure means more volatile. More volatile substance will have minimum boiling. Okay, so that is the reason we said to be minimum boiling azeotrope. So ethyl alcohol, when you take 95.6%, water 4.4%, it forms an azeotrope. Let's see the boiling points. For water, we know that what is the boiling point of water? 373 K. Similarly, for ethyl alcohol, it is 351.5 K. Boiling point of water 373. Boiling point of ethyl alcohol 351.5. Next, boiling point of this mixture. Look, pure compound and this mixture will not have some boiling points. Pure alcohol, this is the boil. Pure water, this is the boil. When it is both with this composition, then this boiling point is 351 K nearly. What is the value? 351. See, the azeotrope is having lesser boiling point than the pure components. That is minimum boiling azeotrope. See, the graph related to this minimum boiling azeotrope. Okay, this side take ethyl alcohol, mole fraction of ethyl alcohol, C2H5OH. Let it be 1. Next, mole fraction of water 0. This side water 0, ethyl alcohol maximum. Next, that side. So, by the addition of small amounts of water to this, so increases the concentration of water. Na? That's why when you go from left to right, at the right hand, what happens? C2H5OH, mole fraction is 0, water mole fraction is 1. Now, let's see the graph related to this is mole fraction graph. Now, this side of water and temperature, how is it related to the composition? Here, let us draw temperature versus composition. Previously, we have discussed about pressure versus this composition. Here, we will explain the azeotropic picture. Let us discuss about the temperature versus mole fraction graphs. So, for this ethyl alcohol and water azeotrope, So which percentage is more? That means the mixture azeotrope is formed towards the ethyl alcohol. Right? Towards ethyl alcohol means more percentage of ethyl alcohol. So minimum boiling azeotrope this is. That's why so this is azeotropic mixture. So it is of ethyl alcohol. Then this is the boiling point of ethyl alcohol. Let it be some A. Boiling point of ethyl alcohol it is. Because pure ethyl alcohol is boiling point T naught A. Let it be T naught B. This is boiling point of pure water. So which is having higher boiling point? What is it? Here 373, this 351.5. Which is having higher boiling point? Water. So which is more volatile? Ethyl alcohol. Because more boiling point means less volatile. Less boiling point means more volatile. So between the two, this ethyl alcohol is more volatile than water. Next, here this composition indicates what? Here, when you increase the concentration of water, what happens here? Boiling point of the alcohol decreases until this point is reached. After that increases, this point indicates what? Azeotrope. Here, okay, this is the boiling point of, let it be some, what is the azeotrope boiling point? That's why T naught and mixture. So, what are the values here? T naught A is the boiling point of ethyl alcohol. That means 351.5 Kelvin. T naught B, boiling point of what? 373 Kelvin. T naught M, that means boiling point of the mixture. This is azeotropic mixture. That is 351 Kelvin. Okay. Now, have you heard about minimum boiling azeotrope? Minimum boiling azeotrope. Azeotropic mixture will have lesser boiling point than the pure components. Got it? So let's see the second type. B. Maximum boiling azeotrope. Maximum boiling azeotrope. What is this? This maximum boiling azeotrope is formed by a non-ideal solution which shows a negative deviation from Rouse law. Here, why it is said to be maximum boiling azeotrope? Here, azeotropic mixture will have higher boiling point than the pure components. It means boiling point of azeotrope is more than boiling point of any pure component in the mixture. Any pure component in the mixture. An example for you. When we take HNO3, nitric acid, HNO3 68%, and water 32%. Here also by mass the percentages are there. By mass, that means if you take 100 grams of mixture of these two, 100 grams of mixture of these two, then 68 grams nitric acid, 32 grams of water. It forms an azeotrope. Which kind of azeotrope? Maximum boiling azeotrope. Let's see their boiling points. Boiling point of this one, 373 K, its value 359 K, its value is 393.5. Check out the boiling point values of all these three. 373, 359, 398. That means azeotrope is having more boiling point than pure water and than pure nitric acid also. So that is the reason why it is named as maximum boiling azeotrope. Maximum boiling means it is having more boiling point than the pure components. Okay. Now let's see the graph related to this maximum boiling azeotrope. Temperature versus composition graph. This side along y-axis temperature, along x-axis composition. Okay. So this side take mole fraction of water 1 and mole fraction of nitric acid 0. That side mole fraction of water 0, mole fraction of nitric acid 1. Now which is having more boiling point? See here, water is having more boiling, slightly higher, more boiling point is slightly higher than nitric acid. It is slightly lesser. Which one is lesser slightly? Nitric acid. Okay. See the graph now. So this is a this point in case azeotropic mixture. This is azeotrope formed by nitric acid and water. This is the boiling point. T naught A is the boiling point of water. T naught B is the boiling point of the nitric acid. Similarly, what is this? This is Tm. Value should be more, that's why. Okay, this is the highest boiling point. This is T naught M. Okay, T naught M. So here what are T naught A, T naught B, T naught M? T naught A is the boiling point of water. What is that? 373 K. T naught B is the boiling point of nitric acid, that is 359 K. Whereas T naught M is the boiling point of azeotrope, 393.5 K. That means in this azeotrope is having more boiling point than any other composition. So with this composition only, it is having more boiling point than the pure components, than any other composition of this. So this is maximum boiling azeotrope.